Most people think that Zoom is just about meetings, but there are some useful features as part of the free plan that many people don't know even exist. Today, we're going to unpack them and see whether you, as a Zoom user, could take advantage of them for daily productivity. So before we begin, thanks to Zapier for sponsoring today's video. You can find out more about them below and a little bit later in this video. So here is Zoom Workplace, and they have a free plan that goes beyond just meetings, but they do have pricing for this, which I'll include on screen now. The pro pricing does allow you more features, more access, and of course more abilities, but we'll go through what the free plan offers today to give you all the insights. So obviously the first thing that we know about Zoom is that you can start meetings. This is typically where people start with their meeting experience, and you can join a call, you could do all of the regular stuff like breakout rooms and also local recording. Now you can see all of your meetings once they're connected with your Google or Microsoft account and naturally jump into one. So I don't really need to show you these features. Let's dive into the first feature that not many people know about. The first of those features is something called Team Chat. Now, if you're using Slack or Microsoft Teams and you want to be able to bring this into one housed experience, you can use Team Chat. And this is pretty much like most of the other sub resources out there. You can type in an email address or even just start typing with somebody that you may be working with and start communicating with them. Now, as you can see, external users will be able to see your company name, but what's quite nice about that is you can still communicate with them if they're using Zoom as well. Now, over here, you can start channels, which is essentially a place to build out a conversation that's particularly and specific, a bit like you can with Slack, and you can create folders of conversations as well. You can use direct messaging and use something called meeting chat, and this is quite helpful for having meeting chat specific conversations. So if you've ever used the chat function in a meeting and you're always curious about what is being talked about in those meetings and you don't want to miss out on the links, then this is where they will all appear. You can see down here any shared ones. Now, this is great for any projects that you have with other departments that are part of a conversation that you may want to be involved in. So it is not the most attractive looking chat function compared to the likes of Slack and even Microsoft Teams. It doesn't look fantastic, but it is a good way if you're already using the function to DM or even chat with team members and see any mentions that you have available. Ever wanted to automate things, but you lack the coding skills? You can now do that with Zapier with no code. Zapier is the leader in automation, allowing you to take your workflows to the next level with a suite of automation tools. You can go from an idea to reality in no time, setting up triggers for simple workflows and for even more advanced ones. That's why over 2.2 million companies use and trust Zapier. And thanks to Zapier for sponsoring this video. So the next feature we're going to talk about is Zoom Clips. Now this feature is available up to 2 5-minute videos, and that is the ability to create and record useful clips to send later. Now you're probably wondering, what is this and how does it work? Well, it's essentially like Loom, allowing you to create a video, screen share, and record. So you can choose specific information like what microphone you're using, what camera you're using, and choose the particular desktop, etc. And you can even change attributes like what I look like on screen and how I appear. This is really nice because it gives you a little bit of branding and allows you to record your screen. Now, you can, as you can see up here, record up to 5 clips at maximum. So you do need to upgrade if you want more. And this will replace the likes of Loom if you're using it as a clipping tool. Now you can then send these clips to anyone in chat and use the feature down here called Apps Zoom Clip, and you can essentially clip on. I thought this was an AI chatbot, hence why I communicated with it. So not many other people know, but the third feature we're going to touch on is called Mail and Calendar. Now here is my email, and you can see all of the emails that you get from your Gmail or your Microsoft accounts. And this is really awesome because you can add accounts into one location, and you can even use something called Zoom Mail in the Pro, which means you can turn your new email account and start it from there. But this is in particularly very good because it's a client for you to use. They also have a calendar app, which allows you to see any meetings that are coming up. So this is great for centralizing all of your communication into one app, and it's free to use with some limitations. But impressively, they actually have a not bad email experience as part of their plan. And for those who are using and wanting to book meetings, even using some of the Zoom functionality, like creating a room or a location, and even using things like focus time, this could be a good and handy calendar experience. So moving on, there's a relatively new feature called Zoom Docs that have recently landed on the scene. You have a limitation as part of Zoom Docs for up to 10 on the free plan, but this could be a great place for you to just take notes and organize from some of your meetings. So here you could create a meeting agenda and be able to collaborate on it with others. So you can go up here and share accordingly with other collaborators. But you can also use the meeting from the docs, which makes the document attached to the meeting, which is in particular great. But actually, the documents experience is fairly reasonable. It's got quite a lot of abilities, and it's sort of like an underrated feature as part of the like of Zoom. And you can even see all of the AI companion stuff, which is part of the pro plan, for you to use generative AI and create and craft meeting notes. Now, you can also use tables in here as well. So if you're looking for a basic spreadsheet type experience for you to manage numbers, that's not bad inside of here. And you can also use a range of templates to find and choose meetings that may be more suitable to you, like for example, engineering chats and things like that, or breakdowns for your meetings. You can also see all of your documents, any meetings you have got coming up, and you can create a document straight away to formulate a document around that meeting. So a really underrated experience that is part of the free plan. So if documents are relatively too collaborative for you, then you can actually create notes inside of Zoom, something that not many people know about. Now, this experience is not particularly attractive. You can create a note from here and you can start typing away. You can add things like headers, things like images and other attributes. You can even use some regular text formatting, but it's not going to win any awards. It's not going to replace something like Evernote or even Notion. Whatever you're using, it's probably not going to be a suitable note-taking replacement. But if you use a lot of Zoom meetings and you take a lot of personal notes, it actually might not be bad for you. It's got some collaborative access, but it won't beat the documents experience that you have. It's sort of just like a nice, small add-on that allows you just to get started with some basic notes. So the final experience, which is free and does have some limitations, is something called whiteboards. Now, for some people, whiteboards are a great way to get started collaborating with other people. And there are some great abilities in here. So for example, you can start using this as a whiteboard and you can share this on your screen. It's really easy when you're in the meeting to switch and basically start the conversation that you need to and have this in the background to visualize. Now, in my opinion, this application will not beat other experiences like Miro and even other ones like Concept Board and Lucid Chart and things like that. However, it does give you a good and basic experience. And as part of the pro plan, you do get unlimited functionality with this. You will be able to do the basics, but it won't be revolutionary. Let's just say that. There are some AI content generation experiences as part of the premium pricing that will allow you to do slightly more. And you can also join a meeting directly from here and use other tools as well, like presentation mode, timers, and voting, which might be helpful for you and your team. So not many people know about how much is accessible through the free plan on Zoom. And hopefully this video gave you a better idea of those features and how it works. So please do check it out in the link in description if you are interested. And if you are interested in Zapier, you can find them linked below. Thank you so much for stopping by in today's video, and I hope it gave you all of the insights at maximizing Zoom in 2025 and beyond. Thank you very much for stopping by. If you are interested in tools and tools in general, software for work, then jump into toolfinder.co. You can also subscribe to this channel and get my opinions and reviews naturally. So I'll see you all very soon, and thank you very much for stopping by.